Reactive class, as always. So what did we discuss in the last class? Do you remember?
I discussed one chapter poem.
So we are going to discuss about
one at a time. One at a time. Aldous?
Ma'am, about the poem Invictus, last class.
Okay. We discussed about, not about the poem, but about the poet. Seba, do you remember the name of the poet?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, what is the name of the poet?
Ma'am,
who is this person?
William Ernest Henley.
Yes, William Ernest Henley. I gave you the details about Ernest Henley. What was the unfortunate incident that has happened to him?
And that tuberculosis.
Tuberculosis.
He was affected with a disease called tuberculosis. At which age? At which age?
At
the age of 12, he was contracted with tuberculosis. And at which age his leg was amputated?
17.
Yes. He was 17 years old. His leg was amputated. And I also explained about the disease tuberculosis.
Yes, ma'am.
Ma'am. Ma'am, you also show the Sudas Chandran also.
Yes.
Ma'am, the same person who...
Yes. This is an image of the person without a leg. One of his legs been amputated.
Second picture.
Yes. The poem Invictus was inspired by Nelson Mandela. Then we also discussed about Sudha Chandran. Okay. Her leg was also amputated as she was with an accident. While she was traveling by train. Okay, so we discussed all these things in the last class. And did I give you the meaning of the word Invictus?
Yes, ma'am. Yes.
Yes, ma'am.
What is the meaning of the word
Invictus? Unconquerable or undefeated.
Yes. Is it an English word?
Ma'am, no. It is a Latin word.
Very good.
Latin word that is when it is translated to English, it is unconquerable or undefeated.
Yes, Invictus is a Latin word and it means unconquerable or undefeated. All right. And what is the context in which the poet has written this poem? Where is the poet? When he wrote this poem, where was he?
Yes. Ma'am, in the hospital.
The poet was in the hospital while he wrote this poem. Okay. The poet was going through immense sufferings. His leg was amputated and the pain was unbearable. He had to spend 20 months or nearly 2 years under the treatment. And at this point of time, he wrote the poem Invictus. So the poem is very relevant with his mindset, unconquerable, cannot be conquered, undefeated, cannot be defeated. That is the meaning of the title, Invictus. So shall we move into the poem in detail?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes,
but before
ma'am.
before that, I would like to draw some pictures here on the board. You just tell me what it is, okay?
Okay, ma'am.
Okay, ma'am.
Please give me some time to draw it.
Ma'am.
It's just like a cartoon form.
Ma'am,
I'm drawing it. Yes.
I have a doubt. Ma'am, we have to we have to say what is the meaning.
Yes. You just observe the picture and tell what it is. Okay.
Okay, ma'am. Okay.
I'm just coloring it. Oh my God, it's taking some time. But I hope you can understand.
Ma'am, yes, ma'am. I understood.
Wait. Let me complete.
Ma'am, I also understood.
Very good. Very good. Let me complete this one. Please have the patience. Okay. I love drawing. Do you all love drawing?
Yes, ma'am. I like.
Yes, ma'am. Ma'am, in the house, I am always drawing.
When I was a student, I loved drawing, pencil drawing and coloring and all.
Ma'am, I also.
Yes.
Ma'am, I also.
This picture is not purely clear, but it's a kind of a cartoon picture. Okay.
Ma'am, running.
Somebody is running. But what is the peculiarity of this person?
Ma'am, he's running with only the knees only. He ma'am, don't have
foot. Yes, ma'am.
Yes, he has got knees, but without legs. Okay. What is the peculiarity of his leg?
Running with artificial legs.
Ah, yes, very good, very good. Running with artificial leg. Okay. Now I'm drawing another picture. Just observe it closely. I need some time for coloring, okay? Coloring is also important. Yeah, shading.
Yes, ma'am.
Let's try to identify what is this picture about. Don't say it now, don't say it now, but just observe it and then let me know.
Ma'am, is the picture completed?
Yes, I'm completing, almost completed. I just have to shade it, that's it. What do you understand from this picture?
Ma'am, painted it.
Ma'am, he's standing on an... another person and
is he standing?
Ma'am, not standing.
Not standing.
I mean,
ma'am, he's.
Is the person standing? Or
no,
what do you feel?
Ma'am,
bending.
Huh?
He's fell down.
Is he standing or is he sitting?
Ma'am, he's not sitting. Ma'am.
Where is he sitting?
Ma'am, on another.
Another.
What does this represent? This
ma'am, on another person's back.
Back.
No. I will give you another clue here, like this. Now, what does this show?
Ma'am, he's sitting on a wheelchair.
Ah, very good, very good. He is sitting on a wheelchair. Agreed. Fantastic. Now, what is he doing?
Ma'am,
arrow.
Yes, this is also an image of a handicapped person. He is sitting on a wheelchair and he is doing the archery. He is doing archery.
Archery.
He's trying to.
Archery.
He's trying to do the archery, bow and arrow archery. Yes. Now one more picture. Now, what does this picture represent?
Ma'am playing basketball.
Pulling the basketball.
What about the person?
Playing basketball.
Going
there. The wheelchair.
Basketball. And sitting in a wheelchair.
Yes.
Ma'am, from sitting in the wheelchair, he's throwing the ball. He or she is throwing the ball.
Yes, very good. Very good. Fantastic answer. Okay, so you are able to understand from the way I drew. Isn't it?
Yes, ma'am.
So the person is sitting on a wheelchair and he is playing basketball or he is simply playing with the ball. Okay. So what is peculiar with all these three people?
Ma'am, Alex.
Handicapped.
They are all handicapped. But then you don't find them sitting simply. You don't find them sitting simply, but they are all very active. The first picture shows that the person is running with an artificial leg. Okay. The person is running with artificial legs. The second picture shows that the handicapped person is sitting on a wheelchair and doing the archery. And the third image shows that the handicapped person is sitting on a wheelchair and playing with a ball. So from this, what do you understand? From these pictures. They are not losing their hopes, they are not desperate, they are not upset, but they are trying to do better by themselves, they are trying to overcome their difficulties. They are trying to overcome the problems that they are facing in their life. Okay, so shall we move into the poem?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
All right. So,
ma'am, can you hear me?
Yes, I can hear you, Seba.
Ma'am, I drew it.
Aye, very good. Good picture. Wonderful. Yes, I know that there are great artists in the class. Wow, superb. I have also painted certain pictures and I have stuck it on the room of my wall. Okay.
Yes, ma'am, I did.
All right. So shall we move to the poem? I want one of you to read it. Just read the poem fully. Who will read?
Ma'am, me too.
Fidel?
Ma'am, Fidel, Fidel.
Read.
Okay, ma'am.
Read the first answer.
And page number?
Page number 70.
70.
Invictus, out of the night that covers me, black as the pit from pole to pole, I thank whatever gods may be for my unconquerable soul. In the fell clutch of circumstance, I have not winced nor cried aloud. Under the blood yawnings of stance, my head is bloody but unbowed.
All right. Next, two stanzas. Clara?
Yes, ma'am.
Read.
Beyond this place of wrath and tears.
Wrath and tears
looms but the horror of the shade and yet the
menace
of the years finds and shall find me unafraid. It matters not how straight the gate, how charged with punishments with the scroll. I am the master of my fate. I am the captain of my sword.
All right. I'll read the poem once again for you. Listen carefully and tell me what you have you understood. Out of the night that covers me, black as the pit from pole to pole, I thank whatever gods may be for my unconquerable soul. In the fell clutch of circumstance, I have not winced nor cried aloud. Under the blood yawnings of chance, my head is bloody but unbowed. Beyond this place of wrath and tears looms but the horror of the shade. And yet menace of the years finds and shall find me unafraid. It matters not how straight the gate, how charged with punishments the scroll. I'm the master of my fate, I'm the captain of my soul. Have you understood anything from the poem?
Yes, ma'am.
Ma'am, he is saying he is brave and he will not give up the hope.
Ma'am.
Very good observation. He is brave and he is not ready to give up the hope. Good, Seba. Next, Aldous.
Ma'am, whenever the problems are in front of him, he doesn't give up and bravely he faces the problems.
Very good. Whenever he confronts the problem, he doesn't lose his hope, but he is ready to face it. Okay. Anybody else? Anyone else would like to explain? That's it?
If we have the strong man, we can face the difficulties.
Oh, very good, Clara. If we have the strong mind, we'll be able to face any difficulties that comes in our life. Wow, great. I would like to give clap to all these three students, Seba, Aldis and Clara. Very good, very good.
Thank you, ma'am.
So we'll go on with the explanation. Out of the night that covers me, black as the pit from pole to pole, I thank whatever gods may be for my unconquerable soul. So look at the word that the poet has used in the first line. Out of the night that covers me. Here, we come across the word night. What do you mean by night? Or what comes into your mind when you hear the word night?
Ma'am, dark.
Sometimes.
Yes.
Dark.
Dark.
Yes, very good. Darkness. When we hear the word night, we can relate the word to darkness. Night time. The time of darkness. But it has an inner meaning. The little meaning of the word night is darkness, but it has got an inner meaning. What is the inner meaning?
Ma'am, brave.
Black, brave.
Brave?
Bad no. experiences.
Night refers to darkness. Black. Literal meaning of night is darkness. Day and night.
Bad
During the daytime, we have light. During the night, it is fully dark. But dark, the word night has an inner meaning. Out of the night, not fear. A kind of fear, but mainly, I told you that this poem was written in the context when the poet spent his time in the hospital. Why is he in the hospital?
Horror.
Why is he in the hospital?
Ma'am, because of a disease, he's suffering.
Yes, he was affected with the disease tuberculosis, and as a part of treatment, he is there in the hospital. And what kind of emotion that he is going through? Is he happy?
Sadness.
Why is he sad?
Ma'am, because he is suffering a disease, and he is sad.
He is depressed because he is suffering. He is going through extreme physical pain. So here, the word night has got an inner meaning that is sufferings. Write down in your textbook. The word night refers to sufferings. Okay. So the poet says, out of the night that covers me. The poet says that his life has been covered with full of darkness. He is going through extreme pain, unbearable pain, unimaginable pain. Cutting off a body part means it's not so easy. The pain, unimaginable pain.
Pain will come, ma'am.
Unimaginable, unbearable pain. So the poet says that his life has been covered with full of darkness. Full of sufferings. Black as the pit from pole to pole. Pit. Pit here refers to coal mine. Have you seen coal mine? Coal mine. What is the color of coal mine?
Black.
Yes. Very black in color. Coal mine. The color of coal mine is very black in color. Okay. And pole to pole. Pole to pole means from one end to the other. From one end to the other. Or from north pole to south pole. Or from top to bottom. Okay. So the poet says that his life was fully covered with sufferings. And this sufferings is compared to that of a coal mine, which is fully black in color, from one end to the other. Can light penetrate through black color? Can light penetrate through black color?
Penetrate
means go deep into. Can light pass through black color?
Yes.
No.
No. The answer is no. Light cannot penetrate through black color. Light cannot go through black color. Mm. Okay. Because black color blocks the passage of light, passing of light. So the first two lines tells that the poet, at one point of time, the poet lost his hope in life. Okay, when that kind of sufferings came into his life. I hope I'm making it clear to you.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. The poet is going through extreme suffering, unbearable physical pain, and at one point of time, he thought that he will not be able to have any hope in his life. Okay. So the sufferings that he is going through is compared to that of a coal mine, which is black in color from one end to the other. There is no ray of hope in his life. That is what the poet speaks in the first two lines. But immediately in the third line, we find a different approach of the poet. Adishwar, what are you doing there? Listen here.
History.
The third line, we find a different approach of the poet. That is a positive approach. Positive approach. Positivity. Positive attitude. The word is optimism. The third line, we find that the poet is optimistic. What is he happy about? He tells that, I thank whatever gods may be for my unconquerable soul. He has got...
Can I share the screen?
Yes. Positive attitude means optimism. In the third and fourth line, we find that the poet is thanking gods. He is thankful to the god. Why? For what? Why is he thanking the god? Huh? Why is he thanking the god?
Ma'am, for his unconquerable soul.
Yes, for his unconquerable soul. So children, when we confront problems, when we have to face problems in our life, how can we overcome it? How can we overcome the problems?
Ma'am, if we have a strong mind.
Yes, we have to have a strong mind. A strong willpower should be there. Then.
Self-confidence.
Self-confidence. Very good. Then.
God bless.
And one more. One more point I'm looking for.
Ma'am,
willpower.
Mind.
Self-confidence.
Ma'am, positive mind.
Positive mind. Okay. How will we get the positive mind?
God blessing.
God. Yes, Steve.
God's
blessings. Yes. Very good. Very good, Steve. By trusting the God or having complete faith in God. Okay. So when we are confronting problems, when we have to face problems in our life, it can be any kind of problem, a physical problem or mental suffering, whatever it is. We can overcome such a problem or a suffering by trusting the Lord, having faith in Lord, and by having a strong mind, by having a strong willpower, by believing in yourself too. Okay. So the poet is thanking God for giving him an unconquerable soul. He has got a strong mind within himself that will not be defeated by any circumstances. Is the first answer clear to you?
Yes, ma'am.
For yes, all of
ma'am.
You?
Ma'am.
Clear. Yes.
Yasin, is it clear?
Yes, ma'am.
All right. Now I'm going to show you a newspaper article here. Can you see? Can you see this?
Ma'am.
Yes, ma'am. You see the picture here?
Yes.
Yes, ma'am.
This was a newspaper article that came in Malayala Manorama. Not this year, but last year. But when I saw this, I thought it will be relevant to the poem. So I cut it out from the newspaper. Can you see the lady?
Yes, ma'am.
Two pictures are given. Two pictures.
Yes, ma'am.
One, in one picture, the lady finds so beautiful with a smiling face. And in the second picture, you can see a deformed face. Do you think that both these pictures are of us, the same lady?
Yes.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
This is the picture of the same lady. Okay.
Ma'am, is it acid attack?
No, it's not acid attack, but it is something different. That is, this particular incident happened in Australia, in a place called Kimberley.
Then what happened to her?
This incident took place in the year 2011 on September 12. And she was one of the athletes who has to participate in Kimberley Marathon. I hope you are listening to me.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Yes, ma'am.
Her name is Turia Pitt. Her name is given Turia Pitt. And the title of this article is Born from Fire. So the incident happened on 2011 in September. And it took place in Australia in a place called Kimberley. And she was one of the athletes who has to participate in the Kimberley Marathon. And when once the whistle was out, this athlete started running, and that was a 100 kilometer race. And she had to travel a lot of distance. And this athletes splitted out in different ways, and some of them had to travel through the forest. Okay, and this lady deviated her way, and she took her way through a forest, and unfortunately, to her bad luck, this Kimberley forest area caught fire. Forest fire. Okay, the forest caught fire, and this lady was in the midst of fire. The fire literally swallowed her, and almost 65% of her body was burned. 65%. 65% of her body was burned. And it took hours and hours to rescue her, because the helicopter went in search of these athletes, and after a long time she was found out. And by the time the situation became so severe, and it also took a lot of time to take her to hospital. And then this lady's situation was very, very crucial. Almost 65% of her body was burned, and for almost 1 month she was in coma state. And doctors gave the word that she will never be able to come back into her normal life. Almost 6 months she spent her life in hospital, and she even lost seven fingers. And then it took 2 years for her to come back to her normal life. But then you can imagine how the person's skin and the body, everything will be deformed. Look at her face now. After burning herself in the fire. Earlier, she was a very beautiful lady. But then once the fire caught her, the entire structure changed. And why am I telling you this? Why am I referring to Turia Pitt at this point of time? Because the doctors told that she will never be able to come back into her normal life. Once she was out of the hospital, she decided that she will participate in Ironman competition. Ironman competition is another tough competition that includes swimming, cycling, running, race, and all. It's a combined competition. And a person like this, whose body has been burned almost 65%, will she be able to participate in the Ironman competition? That is the question. And most of the time she cried, because she was never able to accept that her total structure was deformed. She never looked into the mirror for many years. She covered her entire body with clothes. And it was her husband and her family members kept on encouraging her. They injected positivity into her blood. And she decided to take part in the Ironman competition. And in the year 2016, she was able to be a winner in Ironman competition after a lot of practice, after a lot of hard work. She became the winner in 2016. Okay. And later on, she became the Interplast Australian New Zealand ambassador. And in 2014, she was also selected as the Woman of the Year. And she has also written two books, Unmasked and Good Selfie. So this is how the people have different approach towards the sufferings or difficulties in their life. There are people who become totally upset, depressed, demotivated, who never comes back into the normal life. But phoenix birds like Turia Pitt has got the willpower to overcome, the trials and tribulations in her life. Okay. So similarly, William Ernest Henley also says in his poem, he is thankful to God because he has got an unconquerable soul. Is it clear to you, children?
Yes.
What was her name?
Her name is Turia Pitt. Turia Pitt. She was a model.
When we search in Google, she can find it.
Yes, yes. You will find it. Okay. She was good in athletics. She was good at studies. And she was a model also. Okay. Because she was good looking. She was a good looking lady. But then see how fate gives a different turn in the life of people. Life is not so easy. It is a combination of sadness and happiness.
Ma'am, Malala also like that when he get the shoot from Taliban.
Yes. Malala also had the strong willpower. That's how she was able to recover. She was able to survive. Okay. So I hope I have conveyed
what
the message
is her name?
Clearly. Turia Pitt. You can search in the Google. Okay, you will get details about her.
Okay, ma'am.
So I have just completed one stanza for you.
Ma'am.
But I hope I have made it clear to you.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes.
Okay.
Yes,
ma'am. Is it D?
She. Ma'am. It's a lady.
Ma'am. She.
Okay. All right. So we will continue the rest of the poem in the next class. If possible, just go through the lines repeatedly and just try to make your own ideas what that poet is trying to convey. Okay. So is the first answer clear to you, children?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Shall we wind up?
Yeah, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Thank you all.
Bye. Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am.
Bye. Bye.